In this video, we will see how to code the binary search tree without using recursion. In the previous video, we have seen the binary search tree construction using the recursion procedure or recursion as the option. But in this video, we will see iteration as the option because the alternative for the recursion is iteration. So we are going to use the iteration with the help of iterative statements, that is by using while or for loops. So now we'll start this. So I'm saving this file as a binary search tree without recursion. So I'm going to program binary search tree. Without recursion. So here, as usual, include stdio.h. So let will go for copying and pasting of the required things, such as anyhow we have done the binary search tree program previously using recursion. So now I am just copying this function, this construction, that is structure notation for the node. Next, insertion, insert node, node create node. So this also I am going to use this function declaration, and find min, find max, remove node, collapse tree. This also I am going to use here. And next one is, so I'm going to use this tree traversal techniques declarations because we want to print the tree either by in order traversal or pre-order or post-order traversal. And searching for an element in the node, in the tree, that also will declare. And here finally, we have written a main method here, so that main method also will copy this just to save the time. So currently I am keeping this main functions in the comments, so whenever this particular functions are implemented, that will enable this comment, disable this comments, and will run the function to see whether they are working properly or not. Next, we will define the insert node function. So this insert node function need to be defined. So in order to do that, first of all, we should define this create node. So this create node value, so here we are going to define this create node. So how to create, take as usual a temporary node, temporary pointer, and make it as null. Temp is equal to struct node star malloc of size of struct node. Now temp data is equal to value. Temp left is equal to null. Temp right is also equal to null. Then return temp. So this is the creation of a node. Next, insert node function. In order to insert the node, we need to take the help of the insert node. We need to take the help of root node. So for that, insert of ampersand root and this value. Now this insert node function need to be defined. So struct star star node and int value. So as usual, take the temporary pointer and initialize it to null. So temp is equal to star node. Now check whether if star node equal to null or not. If star node equal to null, that means there is no node available in the tree. If star node is equal to null, then star node is equal to create node of value. So whatever the node that you create, that will be the node. Then once it is done, then return. Because so here when there is no node, that means when if the root is null, then whatever the node that you are going to create, that is create node, that will be the root node. For example, if there exists root node, then we are supposed to write it in the else block. Now if there exists root node, then we are supposed to use this particular condition here or assignment here, temp is equal to star node. Then we need to continuously traverse this particular function, this particular temporary value, and we need to insert the element. Either you may use while one or simple for loop without having any initialization, increment or decrement operator or termination condition. Either you may use that or this one. While one means while true. This particular thing will be in the continuous fashion. So once you do this, first we are supposed to check whether the inserting value is less than the root data or not, or greater than root data. If value is less than temp data, then we need to insert it at the left side of the temp, that is root. Otherwise we need to insert it at the right side. So when the value is less than temp data, we need to insert at the left side. So when we are inserting at the left side, first of all we have to check whether the temp left is equal to null or not. If temp left is equal to null, then what we are supposed to do is we are supposed to include temp left is equal to create node of value. So temp left is equal to create node of value. So that means we are going to assign the node to the temp left. And once we assign the node, our work is over. So we need to break. So when we say break, it will come out of the while loop. Otherwise, what we are supposed to do? Else, you are supposed to move to the temp left. Temp is equal to temp left. So this is the way we need to traverse. So we have traversed this in the same way like our single linked list traverser. So we need to move to till the left side. Else, if value is greater than temp data, so by this time you can understand what to do next. So we are supposed to check whether the temp right equal to null or not. If temp right equal to null, then temp right is equal to create node of value. Then break. Otherwise, temp is equal to temp right. That means you are supposed to traverse at the right side of the tree. So this is the way you are supposed to traverse. Else, simply say semicolon, or we can say break or something, which indicates that a duplicate value. That means some duplicate value occurred, so that is the reason we simply break it. This is the way how we can insert the elements in the binary search tree without using recursion. Anyhow, if the value is less than temp data or a value is greater than temp data, in any case, this break will be called and will come out of the while loop. Once it is come out of the while loop, we have to mention here simply return. So whenever it's written, the control will be shifted to the calling function. So this is what iterative way of inserting the element into the binary search tree. So once the insertion procedure is done, we use the inorder function, which is already defined in the binary search tree previously. So just I am copy pasting this into the binary search tree without recursion. Especially this is for testing whether our insertion function is working properly or not. Now what I will do is I will uncomment the things that are already commented here, because I will uncomment the insert node functions and in order of root. These two things I am going to uncomment. In the previous binary search tree construction, we have seen when the inorder is called, the elements will be printed in the sorted order. So let us see whether this code is going to be executed or not. Well, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8. Okay, this is these are the elements that are supposed to be printed. So we got the inorder traversal in a correct order, that is in the sorted order. So these are the elements that are inserted into the binary search tree. Whenever we call the inorder traversal, then the elements are printed in the sorted order. That means our insert node and inorder function is correct. But here one thing is, the inorder function is again making use of the recursion. So our task is to eliminate the recursion. So now what we do is we rewrite this inorder function without using recursion. So in order to use the iteration for the inorder traversal, we need to take the help of the stack. So here in general, the inorder traversal will be like this. The step one will be like this. Set the temporary temp to root. That means the root value will be set to temp. Then what we are supposed to do is, so we need to take the help of stack. So once we set the root to temp, then push the temp to stack. Then once we push the temp to stack, then we need to traverse at the left side. So set the temp to temp left. Then what we are supposed to do, once we set the temp to temp left, once we set the temp to temp left, we need to check whether the temp is null or not. If temp is not null, then go to step 2. That means again this temporary value, whatever the temp left is there, that should be pushed into the stack. So how long we are supposed to do? If till the temp is equal to null, till the time we need to push the temp value into stack. Once we keep on pushing the temporary left value or left side root, sorry, left side nodes into the stack, then at one position the temp left will become null. So thereby this insertion or pushing into the stack will be closed here. Once all the left side nodes are inserted into the stack, then pop an element and assign to the temp. So pop the node from the temp, sorry, node from the stack, and assign to temp. Then once we get this temporary data, temporary node from the stack, just to print the temp data, so that what will happen, the leftmost children element or leftmost children's node data will be printed. So the inorder traversal means left, parent, and right. So this is the way we will print the first we will push the left side values, left side nodes into the stack. Then once we find that left side is equal to null, then pop an element from the pop a node from the stack. That means the last node which is entered will come into the onto the top of the stack. So that will be removed. So it's the data to be printed. Then your next one is that once the data of the leftmost node was printed, then that temp value must be set to set temp to temp right. So thereby what will happen? Now we are going to go to the right side. So right node will be printed now. So that means first left, in order to move to the right side, we need to set to the right. So how long we need to set the temp to temp right? Then set temp to temp right, then go to step 4. That means if temp is not null, then go to step 2. That means push the temp into the stack. Then you push the temp left, then check whether the temp is null or not. Then go to the once the temp is null, then pop a value from the stack. So like that, keep on doing this till all the nodes were visited. Further, this inserting into the stack and removing from the stack need to be done till check whether the stack is empty or not. If stack is empty, then go to step 10. So what is the step 10? End the procedure. So this is the in order traversal using iteration. So this is the procedure. So these are the steps we are supposed to follow to develop our code. That means for this we need to have a stack which can hold struct node address. So that is the reason what I will do here is along with this root I will define a stack struct node star stack of max. So what I will do here is I will define as define max, for example 50. For time being it will go for 20 or something, or let me say 50. It will be beneficial for if the tree size is too large. Next, to keep track of the stack, int top value, which is -1. This is a stack operation. So binary search tree operations. So in top is equal to -1. Then what are the other operations that are required for the stack? So here stack operations. So first of all we need to check int is stack empty. Next, int is stack full. Void push of struct node star. Struct node star pop. So these are the functions that we are supposed to define. So let we'll define these functions before in order traversal. Let we'll define these functions. So int is empty. When can we say whether a stack is empty or not? If we can say return top equal to -1, then 1 else 0. When can we say stack is full? When the top pointer reaches the max. Return if top equal to max, then return 1 else return 0. Next, pushing the element into the stack. That is how, when can we push the element into the stack or node into the stack? If not is stack full, we can push into the stack stack of plus plus top is equal to struct node node. So we can insert it to the stack. Else printf stack is so once it is over, then we need to define the pop. So when can we pop the element from the stack? So first of all, we are check if not is stack empty, then return stack of top minus minus, else return. So this is the pop operation. So stack operation, node stack operation was completed. Now we should move on to the inorder traversal, that is implementing of this particular algorithm or this particular steps procedure for implementing the inorder traversal without using recursion. Now we'll define the inorder traversal without recursion. So anyhow, we have written this particular small algorithm here. We follow the same algorithm. So here struct node star temp is equal to null, and temp is equal to node. Up to here it is fine. Then what we do is we'll initialize one flag. Flag is equal to zero, because when the stack is empty, then we have to return from the infinite loop, because it is an iteration. We have to go to the left side and the right side continuously. So the reason how long we need to go continuously, if we won't mention any exit condition, what will happen is this iteration will fall into the infinite loop. So that is the reason what we are going to do is we are going to make a use of a flag point, flag variable, which is initialized to zero. Once the stack is empty, then we'll set the flag to one. Then it will come out of the loop. So how long we need to go while flag not flag means true, while flag means false. So if the flag is one, while that means any positive value will become true, any negative value or zero will become false. If not false means while true means this loop will execute for infinite number of times. Okay, once whenever the flag will become one, then not true, that means false. While false means the loop will end. This is what the idea behind this flag is. So first of all, you have to check whether the whether the temp is equal to null or not. If temp not equal to null, then what you are supposed to do is you are supposed to push the temp to stack. So push off temp. Once you push into the temp into the stack, then we need to set temp is equal to temp left. So then temp left, if temp left is not equal to null, then push it into the stack. Like that, keep on going till the temp left is equal to null. It means traversing to the leftmost direction to have left parent right, this particular thing. So if temp is not equal to null, that means if temp is equal to null, then what we are supposed to do, we have to go for parent and right only. So there is a reason we make it is else. Okay, that is if whenever the temp is equal to null, then this particular else part will be executed. Since we pushed the leftmost nodes into the stack, and we are supposed to push, we have to pop the leftmost nodes which are pushed into the stack out, and we are supposed to make use of the nodes that are inserted into the stack. So for that we have to keep on checking that if not is stack empty, till the time we are supposed to go. are supposed to make this particular thing. That is, temp is equal to pop. So whatever the last inserted node will be there, that will be assigned to the temp. So according to our algorithm, whenever you get the node reference via pop, you are supposed to print the data of that. So let will print this printf percentile d some space, then temp data. Okay, temp data. So next is once we print the temp data, then we are supposed to set the temp to temp right. So here traverse in the traverse to the right side. So temp is equal to temp right. Now if the temp or if the stack is completely empty, then we need to go for else. If the stack is completely empty, then we don't need to pick any element from the stack. So in such a cases, what we can do is we have to set flag is equal to 1. So now the iterations will be stopped. So while not flag, if temp not equal to null, push the elements into the stack, that is node into the stack, then move to the left side. Then else what will happen is check whether the stack is empty or not. If stack is not empty, then pop the node from the stack and print the particular node data. Then what you do is temp is equal to temp right, you move the right direction. Then again, since it is in the infinite loop, temp is not equal to null, then this particular right side value will be pushed into the stack, then it will go to the left side. Like that, it keep on printing the tree till all nodes were printed in the left parent right fashion. So this is what the inorder traversal in the by using the iteration. Now we will see whether this particular code is going to execute successfully or not. Same thing, I didn't made any changes, simply I passed root to inorder. This is the inorder function that I have defined just now. Now we'll run the code. Well, we got this 1 2 3 4 5 6 8, which is in the ascending order of the elements in the tree. So we already seen in the previous video also, and in the current video also, whenever you use inorder traversal, elements will be printed in the ascending order. So this is with this inserting the element into the binary search tree, and inorder traversal is completed. So for the preorder traversal or postorder traversal, we are supposed to use the stack only for doing the for traversing the tree without using recursion. So the stack application or stack requirement is there for the inorder traversal or preorder traversal or postorder traversal. So so we need the stack to be used for these traversals. So that is the reason whenever we use stack for the preorder traversal or postorder traversal, or for the continuous inorder preorder postorder traversal, sometimes the old references may be stuck up in the stack. So now to stuck up all the old things, I want to initialize the stack whenever I am using the inorder preorder postorder. So that is the reason I am writing a function init stack, so which is initialization. So what this initialization means, I will define the initialization over here. So the initialization is init stack. So here for int I is equal to 0, I less than max, I plus plus. So all the slots of the stack I am initializing with null. So this is what the initialization of the stack. So I am using this initialization in the inorder traversal, initialize the stack, init stack, so thereby initialization will be taken. So the same initialization we will do for the pre-order and post-order traversal also. Now what we'll do is we'll define the pre-order and post-order traversal. So in the pre-order traversal, what will happen? In the in-order traversal, we'll visit the left child first, then parent, then right child. In the pre-order traversal, first parent will be visited, next left child, and next right child. The same code will modify to visit the parent first, then left child, then right child. This is what the pre-order traversal. So void pre-order traversal. Struct node star node. As usual, we'll take a mp is equal to null, mp is equal to node, net stack, installation takes place. First, we need to check whether this root is empty or not, or the node value is empty or not. If temp is null or node is null, then the root is null, thereby there is no tree. So if temp is equal to null, simply return. Otherwise, we need to perform the pre-order traversal. So I am using this assignment and all after this, because before assignment is not required, because if temp is equal to null, then nothing to do in this. If temp is not null, then only it will come here. So that is the reason. First assignment will be done here. Then initialize the stack. After initialization, since the pre-order traversal, in the sense, pre-order means first parent, then left child, then right child. So initialization of stack is done. Then after that, push off temp. So which is the starting node and root node. We are going to push it. So once we push it into the stack, and we need to check whether the stack is empty or not. If stack is not empty, then pop the node from the stack, because the first node what we have inserted is the parent node. That is the root node. So its corresponding data you are supposed to get. So if not is stack empty, then we need to perform the pop operation, so that the temp value will get it here. So if not is empty, then what we are supposed to do? Temp is equal to pop. So we'll get the data. Then printf percentile d temp data. So once we done this, then the root value will be printed. Then we are supposed to visit the left, then we are supposed to visit the right addresses. So in order to visit the left address and right address, so first what we are supposed to do, since when you are visiting the left and the right, you are pushing into the stack. But if you visit left node and push into the stack, that will come at the end. So we need the left to be come first. So the reason it is required to insert the right nodes first, so that right nodes will be at the end of the stack and left nodes will be at the on top of the stack. So that is the reason we'll check whether if temp has right, if temp has right, that is, if temp right is not equal to null, then push temp right. Then if temp left is not equal to null, then push temp left. Now what will happen? Since we pushed the right nodes first into the stack, it will be at the end of the stack. Now if temp left is that, then afterwards temp left will be pushed into the stack, so it will be on the top of the stack. Now since the stack is not empty, so we'll pick the left side value and we'll print the corresponding data. Then we'll get the right side value and corresponding data. Next, right side values, left side value, right side value, like that it keep on taking the values and printing onto the screen. Well, here this is not if, we are supposed to traverse, because it is an iteration, it is, we are supposed to do till while not is stack empty, the same thing has to be repeated. So till this stack becomes empty, the get the element from the stack, then print the node value, then push the its right, then push its left, get the value, push, print the left value, then print the right value. It keep on going till the stack becomes empty. Now we'll run this code and we'll see whether this function is working or not. So previously in the main method, we have uncommented till inorder traversal. Let we'll skip this comment after preorder traversal. That means the preorder traversal will print the parent left and right value. Let we'll run this code. Well, so 6215348. Whenever you perform the preorder traversal, that we got here. That means our the preorder function that what we have written is working successfully. Now we look at the postorder traversal. So we completed the preorder traversal and inorder traversal. Now we'll see the postorder traversal. So void postorder of struct node star node. So the postorder traversal, first of all you need to visit right, sorry, left, right, and then parent. So as usual, we'll take the temporary node temp equal to null. If that will check whether the node is empty or not. If node is equal to empty, that is node equal to null, simply written, nothing to do in this. Otherwise what we do is temp is equal to node. Now first we need to traverse towards the left side, then right side, then the parent. So this has to be continued and these values to be pushed into the stack. So here I'm going to use a do while loop. This do while loop especially used to check whether the stack is empty or not. That means this do while loop will repeat till the stack is empty or not. So while not is empty, not is stack empty, till the time this particular do while loop will repeat. In this while temp, so when the temp is there, till temp not equal to null, so first of all we need to check whether the right side is available or not, because first we need to visit the left means first if you push the left into the stack, then it will be at the end of the stack. So always we need to push the right into the stack, then we go for the left to be inserted into the stack, then the left value will be on the top of the stack. So that is the reason while if temp right is available, then push the temp right. Okay, then else otherwise what we are supposed to do is push the temp itself, that is parent, then temp is equal to temp left. So if again it is having right, then that right will be pushed into the stack. So for understanding, we'll write here push the right child to stack and then parent, then here set the temp to temp left. Now almost all nodes were pushed into the stack. Now you pop one node from the stack and set it as temp. Pop an element, pop a node from stack and set it as temp. Once it is set as temp, check whether this particular popped element, popped node consisting of right child or not. If temp right, okay, and stack of top, that is stack top is equal to temp right or not, that means whether it is already processed or not, we are supposed to check it. If it is already processed, then no need to do this. If it is not processed, then we are supposed to push this particular right side node into the stack, then remove this particular right child from the stack, then we are supposed to push the temp value into the stack, because temp consisting of the left value which was popped just now, and if it is having right side value, then the right value need to be processed, and once it is processed, the parent value, what are the parent value will be there, that will be pushed here. Then we are traversing to the right side of the tree. So this is the way we will go for. If it is already processed, that means if the right child is already processed, then what you're supposed to do is simply print this particular data, because we need only temp data to be printed. Once we print this temp data, then what we'll do is we'll make the temp as null. So once it is made as null, then again this particular do while will repeat. Since the elements are pushed into the stack, some elements will be there. So once the elements are pushed into the stack, and elements are available in the stack, or nodes are available in the stack, then again a node will be popped up from the temp, popped up and assigned to the temp. Then it will check for the temp right is available, and if temp right is already processed or not. If it is not processed, it will be pushed into the stack. If it is processed, then the temp data will be printed and temp will become null. So this is the way, till the stack is empty, this process will keep on repeating and will print the left values first, then right values, then the parent values. So left, right and parent values will be printed as the post order traversal. Now we'll see whether our code will work properly or not. So to do that, go for main method. In the main method, we have checked with the in order traversal and the pre order traversal. Now I am changing the comment from this pre order traversal and here post order traversal. I'm keeping comment here, and we'll see whether this post order traversal will be printed successfully or not. Well, the post order traversal was printed here 1, 4, 3, 5, 2, 8, 6. This is the post order traversal. So that means our post order traversal is successful. Next, we need to define the function find min and find max. That we'll see this particular find min and find max now. Find min means you are supposed to identify the minimum element. Minimum element means you are supposed to traverse till the end of the left child. That is, you have to traverse till the left side. And for the maximum element, you are supposed to traverse till the right side. It is just like a linked list traversal that what already we did in during the single linked list. The same technique we are going to follow here also. Now we'll define this function int find min. So here find min of we are supposed to pass the node star node here. This is a root value we are supposed to pass into this. And also we'll see find max also. It also will take the node as the view. As usual, temporary pointer will be taken. Star temp is equal to null. Temp is equal to node. If node equal to null, return while temp. While temp left not equal to null, simply traverse this temp is equal to temp left. So simply, since we are reached to the temp left, return temp left. The same technique we will follow in the finding of the maximum also. Just copy paste here. So in the finding the maximum, we're supposed to go for right. But I was still right, and then we are supposed to print the temp data. Now we'll uncomment this function definition, function calling here in the main method, and we'll see whether the minimum and maximum elements will be printed or not. So minimum element in the BST is 1 and maximum element in the BST is 8. So this is what the minimum and the maximum. So next we left over with the function remove node, which is called deletion operation. So basically deletion operation without recursion is a very difficult task. So the reason for the deletion operation without recursion, I am going to make another video so that you can view that particular video. So this is that's all for this particular video. In this we have implemented the insertion, in order traversal and pre-order and post-order traversal. Next finding the minimum value and finding the maximum value without using recursion. We will meet with the discussion on the deletion of a node from the binary search tree without recursion in the next video.